Item number five, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, item number five is a first reading of proposed modification to Forsyth County Ethics Code, ordinance number 77. This is a fairly substantive modification to our code that will disband the Forsyth County Ethics Board as we know it, and will replace it with a new operational methodology wherein a sitting board will no longer exist. It will be replaced by an ethics panel that will be assembled on a case-by-case basis. It will be assembled, or the assembly will be comprised of three individuals that will be maintained on file. These will be attorneys. These will be attorneys that all have offices out of the county, and otherwise, as set forth with some specificity, can have no affiliation or basically connections to Forsyth County. There will be a pool of these attorneys that will be sort of qualified every year. The pool must be no less than 9 or more than 15. The minimum qualifications for the attorneys are set forth in Section 2 of the code. And whenever the county receives an ethics complaint, there will basically be a blind drawing of three from this pool that will then be comprised or to form the ethics panel. That ethics panel will then hold the hearing or conduct the hearing in a manner that is similar to how we have conducted or allowed hearings to occur in the past. So that is sort of the big picture, the paradigm shift, if you will. We still will have an opportunity for the ethics panels to issue advisory opinions. That is the one accommodation. You know, right now we've got a sitting ethics board that can issue an advisory opinion. Well, if someone wants an advisory opinion under our ethics code, you could assemble one of these ethics panels. Now, a couple things to think about. Number one, in Section 6, members of these ethics panels will be paid a per diem for each meeting or hearing, and they will be provided that per diem for each day of the hearing, and that per diem will be approved by the Board of Commissioners. And it may be that we want to approve that in advance so that you're not approving per diems on a case-by-case basis, but sort of set one for the year, and that's the model that we use. A lot of the language in this proposed modification you have seen before, and it is the same. Some of the powers of the ethics panel will be different than the Board of Ethics. For instance, in Section 7, we're not going to have the ethics panels establish procedures, rules, and regulations governing its internal organization. Quite frankly, since they're set up on an ad hoc case-by-case basis, it makes a lot less sense to do that. Also, as to number three, under Section 7 duties, the ethics board may make investigations as it deems necessary to determine whether any violation is violated this article, etc. Not only am I unaware of that ever happening before, but of course that makes a lot less sense with a ad hoc ethics panel that's assembled on a case-by-case basis. They're just, practically speaking, would be no opportunity for them to launch their own investigation. They will be truly a tribunal set up to hear case-by-case ethics complaints. The only other significant thing that I want to bring to your attention is the fact that if you were to approve this ethics panel concept, the board has also authorized me to also strike Section 17, which was the wrongful use provisions of the ethics code. Those are the provisions that said that if there was an ethics complaint that was found to be frivolous, etc., there would be a cost-shifting mechanism to go against the complaining party. That would be stricken in its entirety. The code would still contain that methodology whereby someone that had drawn a complaint, an elected official or a county employee, if they prevail, can seek to have their attorney's fees paid by the county. That would still remain. But the notion of being able to seek cost shifting against the complaining party, if this is adopted as I have drafted it, that goes away. All of it. Mr. Chairman, this is the first public reading this evening. The board cannot adopt this evening. Thank you. Is there a motion from the board to open the public hearing?
I'll move. Sir.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously.
Is there anyone who wishes to speak in favor of the proposed amendments to the Forsyth County Ethics Ordinance?
Good evening, Commissioners. That's a nice tie y'all are wearing. I think it's casual evening for the rest of the world out here. My name's Brant Meadows. I have a little bit of experience with ethics. I, like Commissioner Tim, had an ethics complaint filed and subsequently it was dismissed for technical errors. I'm a little bit concerned that we're going to remove the ability of this board to do an investigation on their own. If there is a proposal or a complaint that's made and it's dismissed on technical errors, I think that the panel should be able to make a determination. Well, the technical errors here do prevent us from moving ahead, but we see something and we want to investigate further, and then their hands would be tied. So I think that that's very important for you to do that. Hold on 1 second. No, Mr. Mayor, I can't tell them that. But other than that, I'm in favor of this ordinance, and I hope that you'll consider a passage with a few modifications to allow that board to be able to do some further investigations if they deem necessary because of some technical deficiencies. Thank you.
Thank you. Does anyone else wish to speak in favor?
Hello, Commissioners. I'm Dan Wolf. I was on the first ethics panel and take that issue very much to heart. I see some wisdom in the changes being proposed. I have a question. Was there any discussion about whether or not we could have a couple of people within the residents of Forsyth County that would also serve with the three attorneys from outside the county? So that's the question I have. And I wonder if perhaps that brings some local wisdom, maybe. And yet, even as I say that, I can realize that, you know, we're trying to separate local undue influence from an ethics issue. So, you know, there's a downside to that. But I'm just wondering about that. Thank you.
You? Anyone else?
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Nydia Tisdale. I live in Muswell, Georgia. I think this is a wonderful idea, this ethics panel that you're considering. One thing I would suggest is that in addition to complaints, in the case of one particular commissioner who wondered if they did in fact have a conflict of interest, they were able to go to the ethics board and get a review, an opinion, an advisory opinion. So I would suggest that the ethics panel have that authority to be able to render an opinion as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any other comments? If not, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. Ken, do you have any comments?
No, just to, with respect to Mr. Wolf's concern, to the extent that you were to contemplate expanding the panels to add some local citizens, certainly that could be done. Y'all will need to consider that. I will just say that's what we are coming away from. I think the notion would be that if you had the outside influence, that perhaps it would mitigate any concerns about that.
I think that was one of the reasons I asked to do this, because we want to remove that.
Okay.
The pressure put on local citizens when they've been friends and family and supporters and employees and family works here and all those. And that, when we heard about it in another jurisdiction, I was the one to brought it forward and say, this is a great idea to do here. I think that is, it's nice to have people participate, but in this particular instance, I think it's better to have disinterested people reviewing it.
With respect to the advisory opinions, that tool is still in the code of the draft with respect to this ethics panel. And finally, with respect to the independent investigation or independent investigative powers, that could be reinserted. There's no particular reason that was taken out. That was not a specific direction from the board. Just as in drafting it and taking away a standing board, the way I was reading that was something that the standing board would have the ability to do. I really hadn't contemplated that the ethics panel might find a concern they wanted to investigate and just didn't feel like they had the tools to do it. So if you want to consider that.
That's another issue. I don't believe the ethics panel is a police panel. It's more of a review panel. If it's a technical issue, then the complaining party certainly can be filed in court. So I would not support that. The judge and jury don't go out and investigate crimes. They just listen to the evidence. And that's where I feel this board, this panel needs to be. I need to be a police.
But we can't take any action.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman.
So no objection from anyone going to item number six.
Sorry, Michael.
We've closed the public hearing, have we not?
Yes, we have.